so far in SolidWorks, when we've done dimensioning, we've been using numbers. For instance, when I open up a new sketch, I can create a rectangle and go ahead and dimension that. So I use my smart dimension tool and I come along here. Maybe I want to make it 2 inches by 3 inches. All right. This is a very simple way to define a part that you know it's always going to stay the same. A lot of times, though, when we define parts, we really want to take advantage of the computer's ability to function as a database. And instead of dimensioning and making just one part, we want to build the model so that it will adapt and change when parameters change. And this is why SolidWorks is called a parametric modeler. It has this ability. So instead of dimensioning the second dimension as 3 inches, I can actually double-click on it and say it's equal to, and then click on the dimension I've already put in, 2, and times some factor. So I could say times, for instance, 1.5, right? That would still make it equal to 3. And if I hit enter, notice that now there's still the number 3, but it has the summation sign in front of it. And in SolidWorks, when you see that summation sign, it means that the number that follows it is part of an equation, or is a calculated number based on the equation. So if I go back to my 2 and I change it to be 3, my rectangle updates and that dimension becomes 4.5. Similarly, if I change it back down to 1, it updates the other dimension to be 1.5. This is a really powerful tool. I can actually do this as I make a feature. I can make the feature, let's say, let me move my property manager a little bit wider there. I can go ahead and make my feature 3 inches, let's say, all right? And that, maybe I want the how that feature is built to be an equation as well. So if I click on the part, so I get my dimensions up here, I can double click the feature and do the exact same thing and say, let's make it equal to 3 times dimension 1. Okay, so now everything is being driven off of dimension 1. If I change it to be 2, the whole part, when I hit rebuild, will update, and now it's 3 wide and 6 long. Okay, very handy tool. This just gives you a quick picture into it. I want you to notice one other thing, though. Now that I have equations in here, notice in my feature tree, I have an equations box. If I double click that, or excuse me, if I right click on that, I can click on manage equations. And this is where you can define equations manually if you want. You can add new equations. You can add global variables. So these are values that maybe you've calculated or you're going to use over and over. And you can put in different features to suppress or turn back on. Lots of power and depth here, but for this introduction, I think we'll just end it there. And you can explore how to use equations.